Hello friends, today we are going to see the topic life processes. Now all organisms perform some basic functions which makes them alive, that makes them a living thing, okay. Now so these basic functions, or you can say basic processes which make them alive, first may be the characteristics. Characteristics means these characteristics makes a living organism different from the non-living things, okay. Next comes the nutrition. Nutrition means taking up of food and converting into smaller molecules. Respiration means conversion of energy or releasing of energy from that food to the body. Circulation. Circulation is a process of moving the digested food to the various parts of the body. Excretion is nothing but removal of waste materials from the body, is called as excretion. So these are some of the basic life processes which make living things alive. In this topic we have to cover all these points, and for the sessions we will see these topics in detail one by one, okay. Now let's start this session. In this session we will see that first we should know what are living things, okay. Now living things are the things which are alive, right. This may include or animals, plants, you can also say the microorganisms. All these things are nothing but living things which we see around, okay. Now what the basic question arises here is what criteria we should use to decide that something is alive. Now for this we can say the most important criteria is movement, okay. Movement decides whether the organism is living or not, and that movement should be without any external help, okay. Now the movements in most of the animals you can see is fast and you can observe them easily, but the movement in plants is slow and very difficult to observe, and it is really impossible to see, as we cannot see microorganisms, we cannot see its motility also, okay. So different animals and plants move in different ways, okay. If we'll consider the example of a bird, it flies with the help of wings, right. So its movement is, you can say, flying. Again you can say a person can walk with the help of his legs, right. So these are the various movement performed by living things. Again comes the plants. Plants move means they move only with some of their body parts, like leaves, flowers, shoots, roots. They grow and they show a type of movement. The examples for movement you can say roots, leaves, etc., okay. So these are some of the you can say one of the most important criteria for living things. Now living things also share some of the other basic properties like cellular organization, reproduction means they can have young ones, metabolism, homeostasis, heredity, responsiveness, growth and development, adapt through evolution. These are some of the other basic properties, or you can say other basic life processes which make living things alive, okay. Now in one by one we'll see all these basic properties. The first property is that living things are made up of cells, okay. All living things are made up of cells. That means maybe animals, plants, microorganisms, all living things are made up of cells. Now, cells are the basic structural units of life, the smallest capable unit of all life functions, means the basic unit which makes them alive. Structural as well as fundamental unit of life is a cell, okay. Now cells, you can say also say now the cells are the building blocks of all organisms which make them living things. Now there are two types of cells. First is unicellular and second is multicellular. Which makes organism a unicellular organism? That means that entire organism is only made up of one single cell. Example can be bacteria and protist. Then comes the multicellular organism. That means organism which are made up of more than one cell. That means many cells. And these cells have specialized functions. Multicellular organisms means they can be animals, they can be plants, or you can say human beings also. Different organisms are made, are all made up of cells. Okay. Next comes, all living things reproduce. All living things reproduce means they are capable of producing new organism of the same type. That means you can say a horse can give young one to horse only. Okay, young one, a horse. So that means reproduction means the organism can reproduce its own type of new organism. Again, there are two types of reproduction. First is asexual and second is sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction means a single parent producing by itself. That means no two individuals are involved for the reproduction. Next comes the sexual reproduction. That means two different parents or parent organisms are required, which contribute their genetic information and they give to a young one. One of the parent give young ones. That means they involve the combination of male and female sex cells. That means sexual reproduction involves two organisms, and asexual reproduction does not only involves a single parent. Okay. Now, all living organisms obtain and use energy. That means living organism has to perform different functions, like means it grows, it develops, it repair, damage, reproduce, or you can say movement. All these processes require energy, and this energy is important, which is you can say metabolized in the body of a living organism with the help of metabolism of different kinds of organic substances in the body. Now, the total of the chemical reactions in an organism, that means here comes anabolism plus catabolism and metabolism. Now, in detail, we'll see what is anabolism and catabolism. So, okay, next session, we'll see about anabolism and catabolism. Thank you.